Welcome to the New St. John Fellowship Telecast, a place where we are becoming an end-time people for the end-time church. Our overseer is Pastor Clarence Stevens. We are located at 1615 North Toby Avenue, P.O. Box 1760, Gonzales, Louisiana, 70707. Our telephone number is area code 225-644-2949. Our email is nsjohn@newstjohn.com. Our website is www.newstjohn.com. Sunday morning worship service will be held at 11 o'clock a.m. Wednesday night Bible study will be held at 7 o'clock p.m. If you need help, we're compelled to pray with you and for you. Our major concern is that the Holy Spirit beareth witness with your spirit that you are saved. Make sure you let nothing keep you from doing the will of God. We ask God to bless you for watching.
You want to give God the glory. Come on, praise, praise God. medicine man. Over and over. I said over, over and over. He keeps right on blessing me. Hallelujah. For you, but he's blessing me over and over again. Hallelujah. That's why I don't mind opening his mouth and telling him, I know you've been good. I know you've been good. I know you've been good. If you don't believe me, think about Houston. If you don't believe me, think about Florida. You ought to find enough in you to walk on. It could have been me, but I... All right. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I feel good, and I give him thanks. Give him thanks. I don't care what you think. I know he's been good to me. And I'm going to thank him. I don't care what you think. That's your problem if you don't want to thank him. But I'm going to thank him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't care what you say. I know I feel good. Anybody else in here? Health and strength come from God. Hallelujah. Oh, you feel good? All right. All right. All right. All right. He made a... We can ready to move on. I guess I need to tell you that. He made a way. Tried to block you, but he made a way. 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 People don't want to see you succeed. People don't want to see you blessed. But God. Hallelujah. Won't he knock down the gates of hell? Won't he knock it down? Give him some glory. Give him some glory. All right. God bless you. 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 You may be seated. If you got anything, you felt his presence. If you got anything. And, if you got anything, you know everything is all right. You know everything is all right. Hallelujah. Everything is all right. Let me just kind of give you a little something to chew on. Then we'll move on. I tell you, let me remind you that certainly that the saved are the just. Now, I want to repeat that because that's to God is the ultimate. You may not know it, you may not believe it, but that's God's ultimate. Yes, the just got to live by faith. The just got to. And if you don't live by faith, you're going to die. You're going to die spiritually. Y'all not hearing me? I said the just, that's the ultimate of the gospel. Yes, sir. Did you hear what I said? That I don't care what else we preach. I don't care what else we preach. The ultimate is you just got to, or else your only alternative is being carnally minded, and that's death. So you got to live one by the other. And if you choose not to live by faith, you're going to die. Simply put, spiritually you're going to die. So I offer you that option. I offer you that option to live by faith, or you can die. Now, you don't have another option. You don't have another option. I want you to know that. So I don't care what's in your heart. I don't care who you are. If you're sitting in this house, you only have one option. The just shall live. And if you don't, we're going to know it. Because you're going to die. Oh, you'll be in here, but you spiritually, you're dead. You will get nothing from the pulpit. You leave out of here empty. And I got to kind of coax you to praise God. You wouldn't pray, you're not going to do nothing. You can't do nothing. But anybody saved. Now listen. When Christ. Christ, God operates in an unusual way. God, you have to understand how he operates. For example, Christ said, where two or three are gathered together, there am I in the midst. But he doesn't tell you what he's going to do. He doesn't tell you what he wants you to do. Only those people that are saved will know what to do. Those that are not saved, they will sit looking, not knowing what to do. But the saved know God is expecting me to do something. Now listen. Don't you find it strange? Don't you find it strange? Here come Christ, said, I'm in the midst, and he doesn't tell you a thing. He doesn't tell you a thing. That's strange, isn't it? But the saved will know what to do. When the saved, when Christ comes, you're going to feel something burning. And the saved knows when it starts burning, I got to... I can't sit still with something burning in my heart. So he leaves it up to you. Leaves it up to you. The saved will know what to do. So that's all you got to do. Look out. Look out. Look out. When Christ comes, the saved going to respond. And you wonder, what are they shouting about? Well, everybody don't hear. Everybody don't hear. Christ could be speaking, and somebody sitting right next to you got it, and you don't have it. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. You wonder why people act this way. That's why they act. Because God has touched their heart, and he didn't touch you. Because you didn't know what to do. Now listen. Now the saved hear me. But those that are not saved, you don't hear me. You looking at me strange, and what is he talking about? Well, get saved. And then you know what I'm talking about. So the just got to live by faith. Meaning this word. This word. That's what the preaching is all about. The preaching is giving you a word. That's why you have to come to church. You can't get it. You can't get it no other way. You can stay home if you want to, but you're going to die. Okay. All right. Okay. You got to hear. How can you hear without a preacher? How can he preach except for you? So the just, now listen, I'm repeating that, that's the ultimate. Now God is shaping a people, and he wants to point to wherever that group is. He said, that's what I want. Right, that's what I want. So the just, if the just doesn't live by faith, God can't use you. Can't use you. You got to live only by the gospel. Only by the gospel. Only by the gospel. Only by the gospel. All right. If you don't do that, you're going to die. There is no in between. No, you're going to die. Do y'all hear me? Okay. That's it. All right. So it becomes a question of believing and receiving. When you believe the gospel, now it's you believe with your heart. You know that, I told you. You believe with the heart. And when you believe something, the next step is you're going to confess it. You confess what you believe. Wait, y'all heard me? All right. When you believe something, you're going to confess something. You confess what you believe. If you don't, that's why I tell you, say something. If you don't confess nothing, you don't believe nothing. But the moment you really believe something, you're going to confess it. And nobody will change it. You're going to confess it. Over and you're going to, whenever you ask, you're going to confess the same thing. Because I believe it. I believe it. I believe it. So if you don't confess nothing, you don't believe nothing. Okay, y'all got it? Okay. You got to confess it. So that's believing. If you don't confess nothing, you don't believe nothing. That's the sign that you believe something when you confess it. All right, everybody. Okay. Okay, you got it. All right. That's the sign. Okay. Now, you don't have to confess it in here. You can confess it wherever you are. As long as you put it in the atmosphere. That, you confess it, put it out there in the atmosphere so that the spirit can go to work for you. That's why you confess it. That's why you confess it. The spirit will go to work for you, combating all the devils and everything that try to stop you from progressing. That's why you confess it. Hallelujah. All right. Then, of course, you receive it. It's a twofold process. Receive it. You got to receive it. When you receive, something is in your spirit. Now, how we know is in your spirit. How we know you have received it. How we know you have received it. There is another sign. You got the confession. Is that right? That's a sign you believe it. That's another sign when you receive it. There's another sign. When you receive it, you're going to see something. You're going to see it in your spirit. Now, let me tell you something. That's why God, when some of y'all, God want to bless you, and God, you wonder why I dream about this. Know what God is doing. Oh, you ought to give him a shout right there. God is telling you, you've received it. It's on the way. It's simple. It's simple. God has made it so you can get the victory. It's that. There's no way you can fail if you obey. No way. You can come in here poor, but if you obey, you're going to leave out of here. You're not going to stay poor. All I need you to do is obey. You can come in here a failure, but if you obey, you're going to succeed. If you obey, you can come in here sick, and if you obey, you're gonna end up well. Why am I so sure it happened in my life? If it happened in my life, it can happen in whatever you ask. That's why when you have not grown to where you need to be, God wants to bless you. He'll show you something in a dream. Because when you receive something in your spirit, you got to see something. If you don't see nothing, you have not received it yet. Yeah. The saved know what I'm talking about. Yeah. I tell you, God is able. I put all my trust in Him. He's never, I can't get y'all to see that, but I'm going to live it anyway. I'm going to live it. Maybe somebody will see it. Maybe somebody will see it. I put all my trust in Him. Hallelujah. And if you see Him taking care of me, somebody might catch on and say, I want what you got. I want what you got. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All you got to do is obey. I'm giving you the word. That's all you got to do is obey. And God gonna do His part. Now, did you catch that? So we know when you believe. We know when you receive. Because those things gonna happen. Those things gonna happen. If you don't confess nothing, you don't believe nothing. If you don't see nothing, you don't receive nothing. You haven't received nothing. That's the way God works. And you're not going to change that. That's why you have a preacher here to tell you what thus. You're not going to change God, my brother and sister. You're not going to change Him. You better change. All right. Hallelujah. Now, it's no reason for no one in here to fail. No reason. When Paul talks about Philippians 4:19, he said, but my God, after you have your account, wait now. After you have put into your account, all right, you got to establish an account. And Paul is talking now. When you read that scripture, you've read it many times. You know what it says. After you have put into your account, then Paul is talking to those people that put in their account, that have an account established. And he said, with that God is. What are you doing? Well, you may not like the preacher, but who cares? I don't care. But you're not my source, God is. Hallelujah. So you don't control me. But God will, I'm in a position when you establish your account and give to the preacher, then I can stand boldly and say, my God shall supply, not some, all of them. By Christ Jesus. Now, when I I say that, what you think God is going to do? But if you don't have an account, you can't get anything out of that. Now read your Bible. It's in there. I'm not making anything up. You think I care? No, I don't care. I don't need anything. I got God. But it's for your blessing. If you don't do it, that's fine. That's fine. Now, forgive me. I'm like Paul. I got the privilege to brag. I don't need nothing. I got the privilege to brag a little bit because God has been good to me. I'm like Paul. I know where my souls come from. All right. God. Now, I've told you repeatedly over and over again, God going to take care of this preacher. Now, I don't care what you do. God going to, you're going to take care of this preacher. He's going to keep me healthy and whatever. Hallelujah. God going to take care. Now, I've said that repeatedly. And it's unfolding right in front of your face. I'm not bragging, but you ought to know that. You ought to know who I depend on. So if you depend on who I depend on, the same thing would happen to you. That's who you depend on. All right. So, you know the scripture. I don't have to read it. Philippians 6 and 7, 18, 19. And he said, Paul said, with that God as well, with that sacrifice, you may make, it's a sacrifice. You may give your last. And he said, with that God is well pleased. When you well please God, what you think going to happen? Then I'll be able to say, my God shall supply all, every one of them. So if you need a job, what you think gonna happen? You won't stay out of job for long, because God gonna, I've spoken it over you.